Welcome everyone, this is Curtin's channel. Now we are back to our new episodes of True Semirang Champions and Comparison, featured by Wild League, League of Legends versus the Mobile Legend Bang Bang. But before that, please like and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click the bell icon so you'll be notified to our new next episode video. Let's do this!
Rengar succeeds by observing his prey from a distance and searching for that perfect moment to pounce on his target and secure the kill. Rengar's a night cat that haunts the dreams of squishies everywhere, and this preseason's giving him more tools for the hunt while giving his opponents more space to react. With the exception of Bullet Strike, nearly all of Rengar's abilities have been changed, so let's start with the biggest, his ultimate. Activating Thrill of the Hunt grants him movement speed and camouflage, meaning that he's visible to enemy champions that get too close, similar to Evelynn. While camouflaged, Rengar reveals the nearest enemy champion and can leap to them for a guaranteed critical strike. Moving right along, we'll touch on his two passives, Unseen Predator and Bone Tooth Necklace. Unseen Predator now maxes out at 4 ferocity, and leaping to enter combat gives him 1 stack right off the bat. After using any empowered ability, the Stabby Tabby gains a burst of movement speed to keep the hunt going. As for Bone Tooth Necklace, trophies now increase Rengar's overall damage, but only stack on unique champion kills. Both the basic and empowered versions of his Q, Savagery, strike twice, once in an arc, and then once on a line. It's also a skill shot, so you can miss it, but it deals more damage and you'll look pretty cool. Finally, Battle Roar now heals Rengar for half the damage he's taken in the last few moments. When empowered, Battle Meow breaks crowd control and makes Rengar immune to incoming CC for a brief duration. When considering your empowered abilities, Savagery isn't always the right option. Choosing the correct skill can be the difference between securing a kill or going home empty-handed. Here, empowering Battle Roar could have allowed Rengar to ignore CC and stick to his target for first blood. Thrill of the Hunt lasts significantly longer than it used to, so you can use it to scout out an area and get a sense of where everyone is hiding instead of just jumping on the first target you see. When you're sure that your target is isolated, go in for the kill.
Rengar was born to a tribe of East Shuriman Vastaya known as the Pilash. The society of this tribe is based around the honor and glory of the hunt. Rengar was born as the weakest son of the tribe's chief, a Pilash known as Ponjav. Ponjav believed that Rengar's unusual size would make him a worthless hunter, so he ignored the child, assuming it would starve to death. The young Rengar fled the camp, ashamed that he had disappointed his father. He survived by eating grubs and plants for weeks, until one day, he was nearly killed by a legendary human hunter called Marco. Upon seeing Rengar's fate, he took a pity on the creature and let it live. Besides, this was no mighty Vastayan warrior worthy of Marcon's blade. Rengar spent months following Marcon, feeding off the corpses the hunter left behind. Rengar still hoped to one day rejoin his tribe, so he took great care in observing how Marcon took down his target. After some time, however, Marcon grew sick of that pathetic Pilash following him around. He put a knife on Rengar's throat and informed him that the only way to be a hunter was to hunt. Then he tossed Rengar the blade and kicked him down a cliff, where he was forced to kill for the first time to survive. From then on, Rengar spent years pushing himself almost to breaking point. He scoured Shurima for the most powerful and dangerous prey. Though he would never be as big as the other Pilash, Rengar was determined to be twice as ferocious. Over time, instead of coming back to his camp each time with a fresh scar, he began to come back with trophies. He polished a sandhog skull into a shield. He braided the teeth of a shrieker into his hair. Then, when he decided the time had come, Rengar returns to his tribe, ready to be accepted as a true hunter. But Ponjav laughed at Rengar and his trophies. He decreed that only by bringing back the head of an elusive void abomination would Rengar be welcomed back to the tribe. Blinded by his eagerness to rejoin his people, Rengar allowed this willy beast to get the drop on him. The void creature ripped out one of Rengar's eyes and escaped. Furious and defeated, Rengar admitted his failure to Ponjav. And, as expected, his father criticized him for it. As Ponjav spoke, Rengar noticed all the trophies adorning his father's hut were dusty and old. The tribal chief hadn't hunted anything in a long time. Rengar realized something. He hadn't sent Rengar after the void creature to prove himself. He sent him to hunt it down because he was too afraid to do it himself. Rengar interrupted his father and called him a coward. Many Pilash were blessed with strong bodies and comfortable homes. Rengar, controversially, was born facing death. He had taught himself how to hunt, and he had the trophies and scars to prove it. Even his bloody eye socket was a trophy and a proof that, though Rengar was born with disadvantages, he never gave up. Rage overwhelmed Rengar as he leapt onto his father and gutted him from neck to belly. With their chief dead, the fiercest hunters of the tribe crowned Rengar in flame roses, making him their new chieftain. But Rengar left the village without pausing to take a trophy from what was left of Ponjav. The chieftain was not worthy of remembering. Instead, he had set off determined to find and kill the void creature that had tried to blind him. Not to satisfy the village, but to satisfy himself.
The scent of prey.
The next story takes us into the middle of Rengar's hunt. Rengar smelt the blood before he saw the dead humans. 6 or so, he estimated. But it was tough to get the exact count, thanks to the number of pieces they had been torn into. Their swords were scattered around, as useful as dull cutlery. He knelt, licking blood from the ground. Cold to the tongue. Still sweet, yet bitter with the taste of iron. It had been spilled less than an hour ago. Turning over one of the severed limbs in his hand, Rengar found a line of greenish saliva dangling from where the arm had been ripped from his body. He raised the stump to his nose and sniffed. The saliva smelled foul, like a corpse that had rotten in a puddle of excrement. Just raising it to his nose nearly made Rengar want to vomit, and he had a stronger stomach than most. He grinned with his wide, toothy smile. The creature who infected these wounds would be easy to track. Rengar watched from the brush as the Razorhide worked its claws around the old man's skull and crushed it between his bone teeth. It howled in disappointment, evidently unimpressed by the lack of a crunch. The giant, four-legged beast stomped through the elder man's tent, crushing it with a single step, then biting at the canvas to tear it apart. Tossing aside the man's bedroll, it howled in delight as Rengar heard the scream of a young boy.
Little one, frightened, good fear, delicious fear, time to eat, time to silence screams, time to pain, pain on the back of its neck, sharp and hot. Something bit it? No. Another pain, then another, sharp stance, something with the weapon, something with some fight in it, maybe something tasty.
Patience gave away, and with a leap, Rengar decided it was time to kill. Rengar held onto the Kirai saber with one hand as the Razorhide bucked back and forth, trying to get Rengar off. With his other hand, he grabbed a knife and pierced the beast's leathery hide over and over. He knew he would never kill the beast this way, but he would get it bleeding, confusing, and with a bit of luck, panicking. The Razorhide dropped to its stomach and rolled over, taking Rengar with it. It was fast, much faster than Rengar would have thought of a creature of this size. He barely had time to rip out his blade and jump away. The two enemies got back on their feet. Blood poured down the Razorhide scales, each scale sharp enough to sever a limb. Combined, the scales created impenetrable defense and thousand small weapons all at the same time. It circled Rengar, sniffing the air. Rengar could tell he would never win a straight fight against it. It was too big, too quick, too strong. A lifetime of scars had taught Rengar the secrets of hunting. It wasn't about being strong. It was about knowing when to withdraw and when to attack. Right now, it was time to withdraw. He sprinted away from the village toward the tall grass surrounding it. The Razorhide leapt after him in pursuit, its feet pounding the earth. Rengar could hear it behind him. He could be hidden in the grass soon enough, but the Razorhide was fast. It would catch up to him long before then. He just needed a few extra seconds.
One-eyed Vastaya will be delicious. Only one thing tastier than something young. Something that just tried to kill you. Stomp the cat beast to death before eating? No. Better to swallow him whole. Feel threshing grow weaker and weaker until it deliciously stops. Unhinge jaw. Bite down. Feel warm sprouts of blood.
Guilty prey.
Tripping. Falling. What? Some sort of weapon revolves. Tied together with leather tangled around legs. Bad. Still. Broke for you easily. But Kenby is gone. Only slight rustle into tall grass to show where he went. Bound into field after him. Kenby. Small. Scared. Me. Big. Fat. Will stomp all tall grass down if it takes. Pain. Force running down hind legs. From where? Behind. No Kenby. Run away again. Pain. New pain. Inside. Annoying. Not problem. Just annoying. Start running. Doesn't matter which direction. Put distance between us. Regroup. Turn around. Where must I? Maybe run away. Maybe hide it. Wait. For Rengar, this was the best part. Invisible within the tall grass. His prey cautious, but not smart enough to be terrified. The momentarily silence before the attack. Before the prey realizes how hopeless it is. Before the howls of pain, and the blood, and the adrenaline, and the joy. Rengar threw his head back and roared. Where roar coming from? Sounds like everywhere. Not roar of anger. Not roar of fear. Excitement. Getting closer. No. This was a mistake. Out in the open. Run. Run back. Hard to breathe. Why? The wound in the side. Deeper than it felt? Throat wet. Choking. Blood. Don't slow down. Where is village? This way? No. The other. Vastaya still roaring. Still getting closer. Run. Doesn't matter where. Just... flesh of metal. Cool air blowing on stomach. No. Inside stomach. Feel self growing lighter. Sound of something wet and heavy hitting the ground. Many wet and heavy things. Look back. Guts, fluid, a trail of red and green. Pain, stinging pain, throbbing pain, stabbing pain, everywhere. Can't stand up. Legs buckled, breathing hard. Hear footsteps coming closer. Sound of night leaving sheep. Feel something. Something new. Something terrible. Not hunger, anger, joy, fear. Rengar approached the prone Razorhide. Its feet still kicking at the air as blood poured from the massive slash across its belly. Its eyes were dilated. What trophy would he take? The skull? The mane? The creature lifted its hand and worked its jaws, biting at the air out of anger or confusion. Rengar smiled. The creature's bone teeth were sharp, smooth. One of those would make an impressive addition to his necklace.
Another piece for my collection.
And that was the story of Rengar. Obviously it will be expanded when the Void update finally arrives, and we get more of the Kha'Zix part, but until then, that's pretty much all we have. It is nice to see that Rengar was placed near Shurima, because it now makes sense how Kha'Zix got there, since Ikathia is pretty much the main source of Void creatures in Runeterra. But anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to click the like below and subscribe if you'd like to see all the new stories.